everybody loves the environment, right? Everybody has a story about the first river they paddled on, or their first hunting trip, or the first time they were in the woods. It's such a universal experience for people in Wisconsin.
The lakes, the prairies, Door County, the Baraboo Hills, the Great Lakes, it just keeps having more and more things to show me.
Beautiful crystal clear waters and the stones almost glowing through the water at the edge.
Hearing the sandhill cranes at 5 o'clock in the morning as we were waking up in our tent, and seeing them out in the marsh and walk, even sometimes walking into the campground.
It needs to be places where the grandmothers can take their grandsons to get their feet wet and muddy, because that's the kind of thing little boys like to do.
Water gurgling, sun coming up. Birds are chirping, sunny, it's quiet.
But it's also about preservation and making sure that we're conserving our incredible natural resources in this state for future generations.
I think politics might not be a natural connection with the environment and conservation. But trust me, you want us here. You want the Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters looking out for the environmental ethics of this state. You not only want us, you need us here.
If you are not at the table, you will be on the menu. If we are not there speaking to our legislators about what matters to us, it will be trampled on and ignored only because it's easy to do that.
Without holding legislators accountable, without being politically smart in the Capitol, you can't win. And if we want to protect our air and water, we have to win. We have to win in the Capitol.
So what makes the League so effective here in Wisconsin is they convene groups in addition to doing their own advocacy to make sure that we can work effectively, that you're working with local groups that might be in a community, that you're working with other statewide groups, to really make sure that we're putting our best foot forward together so that we can win.
Well, the League has concentrated on bringing together the hunting, fishing, and outdoor community with the conservation community, and I think it's outstanding.
Something we've really focused on in these 10 years is working with citizens to connect them to the legislative process. It can be so complicated. There's thousands of bills, there's, you know, hundreds of pages per bill sometimes, and we know that Wisconsin citizens want to be involved in the process, but it can be really intimidating. And so what we do at Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters is try to find ways to easily plug voters into the process at the right time so that their time is making the most difference.
So we make sure through a whole set of different ways that we are bringing citizens directly to legislators.
The legislators, I think, have a much deeper understanding that there are a lot of people in their districts that actually do care about conservation and want them to vote for good conservation bills.
Then we have a chance to meet with our legislators face to face and actually kind of maybe, you know, get a little, push them a little bit on things and let them know how important it is to their constituents that they protect the environment.
And this is one of the few opportunities we have to directly talk to them. We've emailed legislators before and gotten a surprisingly small response, disappointingly small response. And a chance to talk face to face with a legislator is a gift to us that the League of Conservation Voters has provided.
I can't tell you how impressed I've been with the hundreds of people who come through the Capitol with Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters lobbying on really good conservation or lobbying against some very bad conservation policies and the impact that that has on legislators.
A lot of what's taking place in the resource area today is determined by decisions that are made by politicians here in Madison. And the League, by holding those people accountable, I think is letting them know in no uncertain terms that there's a lot of us out there that care about the environment and want good decisions made about those resources.
What the Conservation Scorecard has done is demystified the legislative process. It's made it transparent. So if you're a voter who cares about clean air and clean water, if you're a voter who cares about hunting and fishing and open spaces, you know that at the end of every legislative session, you're going to get the conservation scorecard, and it's going to tell you if your senator and assemblyperson voted for the issues you care about or against them. And it helps you decide how you're going to cast your vote.
The league is smart enough to know that when the legislature adjourns and you go into the campaign season, that matters too. And what we found is when there's strong support from the league and others to fight for environmental issues and candidates who support those issues, we can win because the public agrees with us and they care about these issues. But if it's not there, if there's silence, we're hard-pressed to win.
I was repeatedly asked at the door, well, who is supporting you? And it was so critically important for me to say, well, the Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters are supporting me because I am pro-conservation. I'm going to be a champion on these issues. And I know from my experience out in my community how deeply the Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters is trusted by voters.
What makes the Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters different is it really is about the issues, and party is really secondary or sometimes not even important at all. What the league is looking for is people who will be real advocates and champions for the environment, and that's about issues, and that's about demonstrating a real passion and an understanding for those issues and our natural heritage here in Wisconsin. And if you demonstrate those things, I think the Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters have proven over and over again, regardless of party, if you're a champion for the environment, they'll be there and they'll be successful in helping you win.
Well, some people have called it the worst anti-environmental legislation ever introduced in Wisconsin.
Would be extremely destructive to our environment, to our waters, to our soils, to our way of life.
You know, it was such a bad proposal.
It was a terrible bill.
It was a bad piece of legislation which would have allowed an out-of-state strip mining company to come in and do a giant mine in the northern part of Wisconsin, one of our most pristine areas, and pretty much be exempt from environmental rules. So from a legislative standpoint, I just feel it was a terrible bill.
What it can leak are toxic chemicals, and that raises a significant concern for me.
Well, in Wisconsin, most of us get our drinking water from groundwater. That means that drinking water in areas around mines could be contaminated with things like mercury and arsenic and lead.
The Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters paid for a bus that would transport citizens hoping to voice their opinions about the controversial mining bill.
A new mining law would have been a signature piece of legislation for both Governor Scott Walker and this current Republican legislature.
After more than a year of planning, there will ultimately be no iron ore mine.
Ultimately, it's the work that Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters has done for the past 9 years, preparing citizens and educating them for a moment just like this that handed Governor Walker his first defeat.
Stopping the open pit mining bill was a big win, especially in light of this administration and its steamroller political tactics. League of Conservation Voters was able to energize and mobilize the public when they understood the terrible threats that were in play against our environmental regulations and all the stewardship that had gone before.
I was so grateful to you all and your members, and so proud of all the incredible work you did mobilizing your supporters, mobilizing people who cared about this issue to fight as hard as we could for our environment and for our children at the end of the day.
I invest in the League because I really believe that the League is the way to accommodate a wide range of people and their concerns and do it civilly and do it with justice and do it with concern for people and the environment.
The League of Conservation Voters, to me, is the most important, most influential conservation group that I can think of.
I think the League's role in protecting the environment has been essential in this state. And so for people who are passionate about fishing and clean rivers and air that won't give their kids asthma, this was a place to be. This is finally a place to go that they could be political and be environmental at the same time.
I think the Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters is the most effective nonprofit I have ever been associated with. And it makes it a joy to be a part of, because you know that if you give a dollar or an hour or a mile on your car, that all of those are going to be applied in ways that protect the environment, protect the conservation ethic of the state of Wisconsin.
And so we've been really, really lucky here in Wisconsin with the Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters. It's really become an influential and important environmental organization, and I would even argue one of the most important organizations in politics altogether.
I am so proud to be a part of Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters. I have so many separate little moments where I know they wouldn't have happened, accomplishments that I know wouldn't have happened without our organization being there to make them happen. I think of Governor Doyle signing the Great Lakes Compact. I think of Senator Chris Larson defeating a sitting Democrat in a primary to go on and be a top conservation leader in our state. And I think of defeating an open pit mining bill where nobody else thought that would ever be possible, and we did it.
Congratulations to the Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters. Without you, Wisconsin wouldn't be the same.
To the staff of the League of Conservation Voters, you have been fabulous these last 10 years. We expect the same and more in the years to come. Good luck. Congratulations.
I just wanted to wish Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters a happy 10th anniversary and great success on their first decade, the first of many to come.
Happy 10th anniversary, Wisconsin League of Conservation Voters. Keep doing what you're doing to keep our lakes clean, our water safe, and our kids playing outside.
Congratulations, WLCV. Happy anniversary, and I love you.
Oh, that's a good one.